I'm Isaac Mwanza from the Republic of Zambia. At home, I'm the governance advisor of the Young African Leaders Initiative, which is a non-governmental organization registered under the Companies Act. There's a lot of history in the United States, history that that tells you that human beings are capable of doing some good in life. Despite where we're coming from, the slavery that took place, there's been a greater commitment on the people in the past to try and focus on the future and prepare a future that is more better, that is more humane for everyone else. And that to me is an inspiration. When you get to think about what we are doing here, it's actually amazing because I'm learning a lot about leadership. Even from the people that I interact with, you can see the kind of leadership that they are providing. So to me, it's a learning moment as to how I can become a better leader back home. It is a learning moment as to how to change Africa. It is a learning moment for me to rethinking how we're able to groom young African leaders when we get back home. I would also like to think that I've learned the value of public-private partnership. When you look at the sponsorship of this program, it has been sponsored by ELCOM and together with the University of Virginia, the Presidential Precinct. Now, ELCOM is a private company. They have taken interest in sponsoring young African leaders who are going to come to Virginia to learn. That is awesome. It doesn't happen back home. What we know about America is that it is not a country of short programs. It is a country of long-term programs. So our core is, we would like to see that the Young African Leaders program should be funded even after President Obama leaves office. We'd like to see the numbers increased year after year to ensure that a lot of our friends can come to the United States and learn, so that when they get back home, we have more numbers of young people able to bring about change in their communities, in the work that they do in the private sector, in government, and in civil society. I feel inspired that despite all the limitations that we have back home, despite all the things that are happening, the negative things that are happening back home, we can make Africa a better continent. We can plan for the future. We may not enjoy the future ourselves, just like Jefferson and Madison did not enjoy that future, did not live to see that future. But we can enjoy that future, but we need to plan it now.